Ladies and gentlemen, I am back and I have answered your request. I am finally doing a cooking video. Ooh, yeah. The Super Bowl is coming up and I thought I'd do something fun for my friends when they come over. So I found this old clip of Harold and Kumar going to Whitecastle celebrating their, well, I don't know, their kind of comeuppance, I guess. But yeah, shout out to Benji and Babish and Sam the Cooking Guy. They basically inspired and gave me the recipe to do this video. So make sure to check out their channels. I'll leave their link in the description. They're really fun. I love watching them so much. But yeah, here we go. Oh, there I am. Hello. What's up, Ann? Got all the ingredients. Don't worry, that duct tape's not actually part of it. I know what you guys are thinking. Anthony, why is there raw meat in your bedroom? And, well, to be honest, isn't there always raw meat in my bedroom? Know what I'm saying? Just kidding. No, I want to put this in front of my window because this was the best lighting at the time. So we're doing this in my bedroom. But yeah, guys, for this recipe, we're going to need a little bit of parchment paper. Want to roll this across if I can get this open. Oh, I'm struggling already, guys. This might not turn out great. But yeah, we're just going to lay this across and we're going to need a little bit more space so you can fold the paper over the meat, because we're gonna roll the ground beef onto this little square cutting board I got to my left there. There you go. Size it up. All right. And all right, let's do this. Oh, you're gonna see me struggle. Whoa. Oh, oh God. That does not look good. Here we go. Oh, die, die. Michael Myers. Oh, shoot. Oh, watch out. Don't cut yourself. Nice little square rack of meat for you. Oh, the Hawaiian bread smelled so good. Yeah, you hear me say, oh, so good. I'm only making a small batch, so I'm gonna use about half, maybe a little less than half, maybe like six, but oh, there you go, sword flailing. Make sure you massage the meat, get it ready before you get to it, and we're gonna start rolling. I started using a more unconventional tactic here because my rolling skills were not up to par. There you go, I'm measuring it up, make sure it fits. Now we're just gonna perfect the square a little bit. We're gonna cut a little bit of that raw beef. Oh, yeah, I don't wanna touch, yeah, get it off to the side. Now we're just gonna section it off with my little mold. You can make about 12, and I realize that it's a little uneven and I slam it. Oh yeah, don't get frustrated, Anthony. This rolling pin was really bothering, so I'm like, yeah, yeet, yeah, see ya. There we go. Look, we got 12 little patties for us later. You can see me running to get something, and I get the magic tool of this whole video. The Whitecastle secret is they poke 5 holes in each of the little patties to allow the steam to cook the tiny burgers so they can cook evenly, because they actually cook it on the onions, not an actual grill, folks. Revolutionary. Also, I got one of these metal straws from Francesca's cabinet. No one tell her, okay? You just poke the holes, pull a little bit of meat out so you have a clean straw at the end so I can put it back. And I'm just gonna rush through this because this actually took a really long time. And there you go. All the holes are poked in. We're just gonna collect the little meat, pad up the corners a little bit. We're gonna make this as perfect as possible. We're just gonna slide this underneath. And I almost dropped the entire thing. That would have been bad. It would have smelled really gross in my room. All right, so now we're gonna pop these in the freezer for a couple hours, and I'll see you guys in a second.
2 hours later.
What's up? I'm back. Oh, check out my outfit. I call this the pink lemonade out. Anyway, we got our square patties all frozen, perfect. Oh, nicely done, Anthony. We also have our flat top grill. That's already hot. Don't touch that. I also got some nice fresh jalapeno, and I got the classic White Castle white onions. All right. Oh, do some bicep curls, Anthony. Ooh, sexy. First, I'm gonna cut the top of these jalapenos off, and since I am serving them to my white wheat friends and to ensure that they don't scramble for the toilet, I'm gonna get rid of all the seeds. Next, I'm gonna show you a technique to cut this onion that will give Gordon Ramsay a run for his money. First, we're gonna make 2 horizontal cuts, one near the bottom, one near the top. Next, we're gonna cut all the way towards the root, but we're not gonna cut all the way across the root. We're just gonna keep it slightly below so we don't cut through the entire thing. Now, we're gonna hold it all together. Now watch this. One slice, we'll get some diced onions. Oh, well, that was a bad slice. Oh, oh, there we go. Oh, oh, kill him. Oh, kill him. Nice. Perfection. Look at all those diced onions. All right, I think we're good. Clean up the workstation a little bit. Now we're gonna throw all those onions on the grill so we can get those steaming and reduce them a little bit. Wow, look at all that steam already. Jalapenos in. Nice. Next, we're gonna add our secret ingredient is Anthony Kumar's Kumi Kum juice. Nope, just kidding, it's beef broth. These are beef burgers, so we're gonna increase the flavor a little bit. And then we just go ahead and lay the patties on there. The steam from the onions is actually gonna cook them, and they're so thin that we don't need to actually flip them. Wow, Whitecastle, changing the game since 19-something. You see me run off camera here because I forgot the 2 essential ingredients for anything. Seasoning. Unlike the common misconception that white people don't season their food, in the Kumar house, we're doing stuff a little differently here, folks. Just kidding, we don't actually believe in those common stereotypes. In fact, I like to keep this channel PG, you know what I'm saying? Oh shit! Thank God that had a cap on it. All right, let's keep going. Like I said earlier, this is just my demo, so I'm gonna make a smaller batch of about 6. So I'm gonna get all my Hawaiian bread ready. Oh wait, Anthony, you idiot, you forgot the cheese. But wait, this cheese is way too big. How are we gonna put these on the burgers?
All right, well that's healthy. Nice, that's sanitary, keep it going.
Let's just grab our bread and just lay it right on top of the cheese and just cut the outline of the cheese out from the bread. Wow, oh my God, we're changing lives over here, folks.
Yeah, I kinda messed up the other breads, but it's okay.
There you go, salt bay that. Oh, nice, nice. And I got a little impatient, so I just started to flip them anyway. Oh my God, look at that color. Look at that caramelization. Oh, on goes the cheese. Oh, this is looking wonderful. This is looking promising, everybody. And they're about done. Let's get to plating. Come on, flip that. Oh my God. That looks delicious. Keep it going. Oh, and you slowly see the deterioration of my plating. Oh, the onions are getting everywhere. I'm sorry. I ruined this. Oh God, it's a disaster. Oh my God. Oh, never mind. Quick fix. Switch the plates. And there it is, folks. Your Harold and Kumar's White Castle sliders. Oh my. But it wouldn't be a true food review if there wasn't a taste test at the end. Let's give this a shot. Wow, those look magnificent. Oh my God. And how's it? Oh, you already know. They're delicious, folks. Look at it. Anthony, do you like it? Of course you do, you fat ass. Well, guys, that's the end of the video. If I